I speak for the Orange Democratic Movement. I don't speak for Jubilee.
We are asking that this position be filled in with by another woman.
I guess the deadline should be a little bit extended so that those who have not caught up with the process can finish it.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to News Sources. Tonight, four senior directors of communication in State House are waiting word on their fate after they were suspended in what News Sources has learned is supremacy battles in the House on the Hill. That's where we start our program tonight. Good evening, everyone. I'd like to, Dennis Onsarigo, my co-host, good to see you again.
Good to see you.
Looking like money. Paul Afula. I wonder where Dennis got his money, but yes. And of course, Rosie Nobala. Ladies and gentlemen, PSU no more. I feel that there's a sense of great loss in this republic, in this country today, that we do not have the Presidential Strategic Communications Unit. I don't know if you feel this. Something has left the room.
I think we are lost somewhere, Smart, and I feel for the presidency because this is a group that single-handedly handed Uhuru Kenyatta and William Ruto the presidency. This fellas worked around the clock to make sure the two become first and second in command in this country. And the kind of silence on social media from the government side, it's sickening, so to say the least. Paul.
I think I'd like first to interject. I wouldn't think that they handed, putting the presidency in the hands of these four people, saying they handed over the presidency. It is a bit, an exaggeration.
But these gentlemen walked with the president and his deputy all through.
They are competent propagandists, I can say. I mean, they did a very good propaganda war on social media and everywhere.
All the people who went to school, they went to school. These are competent individuals.
I mean, who said that people who do propaganda do not go to school? I mean, these people are competent. As you say, they did a very quality job in terms of ensuring that whatever message they needed to achieve was achieved. But now, after you have done that, you realize that you no longer need them and you need a fresh team because there's that reason that prevails. You know, Communication is not just about shouting, about hitting back, but it's about also listening to the voice of reason and having some facts and logic behind you.
If I hear you correctly, you're saying that the S in strategic was missing. Is that true, Rosalie?
I don't quite agree with what Paul says. What I think is that when these people came on board, they came into an institution. The presidency is an institution, and we don't go by the two principals who they supported. So because of that, the communication that they were doing was supposed to be surrounded around that. That they should have known that we are no longer representing Uhuru Kenyatta, the person, or William Ruto, the deputy, but we are representing a presidency, an institution. And that is what you are seeing lacking.
I feel, from what I said, I think politically, the biggest problem I think that they walked into was the fact that they came in and they could not fit into the old PPS version of things. You know, the way it was very organized, the way you get in, this is how things were done. You know, these appointments are done in this way. There's a statement that is sent to newsrooms in this way. And they felt they need to, you know, sort of live in the new world, which was, you know, online, you know, send messages on Facebook, you know, tweet them, you know, and create that essentially PSU. And this band was PPS. So I think, in some ways, while that is what was needed, it was a strategic mistake.
No, I don't think so, Smart, because from where I see it, these people brought a new life into State House. They broke down the presidency. To some extent, they made a joke of it. I mean, to some extent, but largely, I mean, they demystified the presidency. They brought people to State House. You see the president jumping up and grabbing a rugby ball. I don't know what it's called. I mean, but this happened. And over time, we started warming up to the president itself.
But then, what was the value of that in the presidency? Because that might have been good in campaigns where, you know, we want someone who's more approachable, you know, looks good, you know, is down to earth, you know, and can take selfies, you know, kiss babies. But when you're president, what was the value that they were adding for presidents? That's what I'm trying to...
And exactly, Smart, this is my point. I mean, let us just say the truth. Some of these people are friends to Onsarigo, and we know they're even classmates. We can't run away. I can say it here that some of these people, I mean, he has lost friends and power and influence.
And we commiserate with you, Dennis.
You know, some of your colleagues. But having said that, Dennis, let us look at that as it is, yeah?
But Paul, I stand guided. But I still insist that these people did a brilliant job.
Now, you know the presidency, when you are when in charge of the communication of the presidency, presidency is not just politics. You know, this is, you are no longer in charge of the Jubilee coalition. You understand? Once you've run an election, and there it is, 2017 or 2012, you've won the election, now you are representing an institution. You know, the presidency is not just about Jubilee and so on and so forth.
But you must speak on behalf of all
Kenyans. Let me finish my point. Yes. I mean, these are your friends, I know. But I'm saying that you can't turn the presidency into another political witch hunt. I mean, you look at it in terms of how do you even communicate? Yeah. And sometimes, I feel for them, and you are right. After the job that they did, it's unfair for them to be locked out of State House. It was an embarrassment, and I wouldn't expect something like this to happen. It would have been a more decent way of, I mean, we have appointed so-and-so to become in charge of what on two things. We have promoted them into something. That's how we go about this kind of state. But if you bar them from State House, you embarrass them, it's not really fair. That I'll say, okay, the process
okay,
was
okay, for me, what I think is this. These people have done a brilliant job.
Yeah.
And they brought us closer to State House and to the presidency, and they opened the doors and we were able to see what is inside. But again, they went overboard. Because you could see some of the tweets or some of the messages they were sending across, and you'll ask yourself, is that exactly what the presidency stands for? So as much as they did a brilliant job, I think they also did, they really goofed at the end of the day. Yeah.
That goof is what I would say that is taking them home, Dennis. Again, we commiserate with, you know, with you losing friends, but
how many friends do I have?
No, let me confess, even me, they're my friends.
We have to make this point, all right? In campaigns, you campaign poetry, okay? You need people to you're rallying people around and you have promises you're making. But you govern in prose, which means that the things that you're going to say, they're going to even sound boring, but you have to repeat it over and over and over and
all your thoughts
over again.
Mm. If there is a department that has pushed the Jubilee agenda online, then it is that communication department that has been sent home. On social media, then the unit that has run government functions online has defended the presidency, insulted the opposition, and to some large extent been accused of being a propaganda tool of the state.
And that's the point. That's the point. That's the point. I think what Paul was saying, that at some point the transition, it took too long for them to transition from being the Jubilee campaign team to an outfit that is providing communication for the presidency. I don't know if that was the point.
I agree with you. They took too long, or maybe they didn't understand exactly the structure of government. Because you see, when you come into government, there are structures that are supposed to be followed. Here is a case where we see the president issuing a statement, and just 2 minutes or 3 minutes later, we see another statement coming from this unit. So which one exactly is a genuine statement that you are seeing?
But James, you can't bury these fellas just like that without giving them a voice. These are individuals who are working under someone.
Oh, Sarigo, do you
and
understand?
The president and his deputy like this. I mean, every minute, these fellas will launch everything from rain to everything, and the president and his deputy stood by them. I mean, you can't sit here and start demonizing people who worked miracles.
Let us start with my friend Itumbi. I mean, he's a director of digital and something to do with diaspora. Okay, let us just start with diaspora. What has it done for the diaspora? What is there we can see in terms of achievement? Do you really understand what diaspora means? Do you really understand the issue of bringing foreign investment into the country? Is that what we are seeing? Are we seeing connections between our embassies when our Kenyan citizens are stranded in Saudi Arabia or South Africa, has visa issues? Where are they? What are they really doing? This is really the job that we should be doing. Not blogging about so-and-so and attacking the opposition.
That was their job.
That was the exact job they had while it was on the campaign trail. But after that, now you become a director of communication. And do you know what a director is, by the way? Before you become a director in government, there are some things that you have to do. And I understand when actually they were appointed to be director, there was a lot of discomfort because, yeah. I mean, there are those bureaucratic old age people who are thinking these people maybe do not have the competent papers to be able to be put
at a level of
a director. And probably this is what has also come to haunt them, because there's also the experience bit in terms of handling government. Government is not just a small unit that you'd wake up one day and issue statements. There are interests interest and there are people involved.
And most pragmatic thing I would say, in terms of politics, the political expediency demands, you know, and I think that's what has happened today, that you put some lamb somewhere that you're going to call sacrificial at some point, all right? Sacrificial lamb. So, in effect, the biggest thing that has propelled Jubilee into office, which was what you're talking about, and perhaps they could have something to do with it, which is the competency, you know, communicating the candidate Uhuru Kenyatta is not the same as President Uhuru Kenyatta. So while the job could have been very well, you know, top-notch on campaign and candidate Uhuru Kenyatta, they did not fit the bill on President Uhuru Kenyatta. And I think that is the distinction of the problem here. So, essentially, they are the sacrificial lamb. So, if President Kenyatta looks and sees, so what is not working, Jubilee, it's communication, who should I blame?
But smart, can the president and his deputy undo this?
I mean, this you cannot undo, but let us just take an example of the recent, what happened. And there's this real competition in fighting that Obala is talking about. Look at a situation recently when Uhuru Kenyatta went and received sugarcane from some lady, and it was really felt, and the whole country really warmed up into the president.
That
and
was then the work of
because of now competition. Yeah. The other gentleman say, no, what is Ruto doing? And they bring up and pimp up Ruto and making him arrive a day
Paul,
later. Then the whole PR machine, everybody realizes PR, it fails, it collapses on its feet.
Paul,
what
agree
do you have to
that
achieve?
For the last 3 years, that's how we've been running things in this country. I don't know why you want us to sacrifice this for gentlemen, and the entire government has been running like this. It starts and ends on social media.
And Dennis, Rosaline, I will allow you to make your point. Yeah. The problem is that now that possibly someone has seen that as a mistake and it's a problem, and they're correcting it, they're saying that, you know, at some point, the president has to be taken a bit serious. There has to be some serious thing that we are communicating and the country, you know, sits back and relax. I mean, you worked in the newsroom when you had to wait for an official statement from State House. That would have been the top news, would have taken days, sometimes even weeks, to analyze what the message within the message. We've lost that.
Yeah, so, smart, I agree with you, because you see, when these guys were there, we expected them to go beyond the politics, the terrain that we had seen when they delivered the presidency, as
Dennis is claiming.
But that is where now they were supposed to step up the game. And I think what the president has done is very good, that he has stepped in and taken charge. That as much as you people, you owe me a lot and I owe you a lot of what we date back, but at the end of the day, there must be some seriousness in my communication. And this is an institution. It is not Uhuru as we knew him. He's the president.
But
so
James,
because of that, we
James,
need that seriousness
James,
coming out.
And Wafula, there's a question you guys are not answering me. This is how we've been running this government for the last 3 years.
But
Can we stop and say that now we are not doing anything because this is what we've been doing for 3 years? Somebody must wake up and say, no, we have to do it the other way. This is a president who is seeking re-elections. He has to turn around things so that he can be assured of his re-election.
Power. Let me tell you something, Osarigo. Power destroys. Yeah. And if you look at some of my friends here, in terms of they went into State House and they forgot that they are Kenyans. I mean, you will tell them that, look, there are people starving and they are going hungry. And they will tell you there's nothing like that in this country. There's even a time when we heard that the Pope was here and people were looking for accreditation. And one arm will tell you, no, the fighting was really intense until, as a journalist, you will feel it. And one day you'll be told, look, this is Manoah Esipisu doing it. The other side will be saying, okay, can you look at the other side of town?
All right, let's grow this conversation. And the Presidential Strategic Communication Unit has been instrumental in portraying the Jubilee government as a public relation outfit. Many election pledges that the government has failed to implement has received backing from the strategic unit. So what gives, again, from the point that Dennis is making, is that this, however I want to say these guys have failed, they served a certain purpose, all right? In the last 3 years, they were the front, all right? We interacted with the presidency on the front of Twitter for the first time. Uhuru Kenyatta is on Facebook and is on Twitter, and he's responding to, you know, our most immediate issues at that point. And that has to be revolutionary. It must be said. It is revolutionary.
James, I totally agree with you. I mean, you're coming home finally. I totally agree with you. And remember, the first year in office for the Jubilee government, media had a chance since independence to go to State House and have a cup of tea with the president. It has never happened.
That's one.
Secondly, I mean, we got to a point where we decided to side with government when our people were dying everywhere in this country because we were one.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We ran hashtags as media houses and bowed. I mean, you work for you did all these things, mm-hmm. you could not differentiate between this communication and what media can do. Thanks to these fellas, they've been running this thing brilliantly as anyone else can do.
So Dennis, let me, before I allow Paul to make his point, let's disabuse you of certain notions. Yeah, the fact that they have a role to play is not in question, all right? It is within what context, in what place, and what freedoms is what we are talking about here, all right? That, in fact, Obama has his own attack dogs, all right? But he does not front them as the communication of the presidency. That's the point.
I mean, look at a situation whereby you come into office, you hire 100 university students, put them in the room and ask them to tweet until you make something trend. Okay, it achieves the purpose. The following day, something else comes up, you say, this is bad, how do we go about it? We again put it up and you put out to another social media platform, you make it trend. Around 100,000 people, 200,000 people will be interacting with the platform, but the real Kenyans who are seated somewhere in Garissa, who are really feeling the pinch, will see it happen. So I don't disagree that these people did not work. Actually, I give it up to them. I have not seen a strategic unit that has worked. I mean, these are, I think, we can put it, say here, without fear of contradiction, it's actually been the best in terms of communication from the presidency. But there's a point where you have to realize that PR is not just about propaganda. You have to stop, to step back and say, yes, we are wrong. This is really true. It has happened. Sometimes you have to accept that you are wrong. You understand? This is something that this gentleman never came to understand. And, you know, when you are into the political arena, at some point, you have to realize that these people really change. Like, you do not know what is going to happen between Uhuru Kenyatta and Deputy President William Ruto. Alliances keep shifting. So you do not know what is happening at the back end, and you are busy parroting at the front. Then people realize you do not understand what's going on, and that's how you are cut off.
But James, there's a feeling out there. I was saying this on social media. I don't know whose brilliant idea this is, saying that these people have been relieved of their duties. They can take up their propaganda role again, as they did in 2013. It could be here or there, no idea. But I agree with you guys, finally, that this team did a brilliant job, but they should have stopped at some point and said, now we're in government, we are no longer campaigning, yeah. We are not on the campaign trail, we're not competing with the opposition, we are in charge of the state machinery, we are in charge of the statecraft. They should have realized that. But as it stands now, you'll agree that we keep on referring to this government as the Jubilee government. It has never been the government. It has never been that Kenyan government. It has always been the Jubilee government. So it's a catch-22 situation even for the person who has remained in office now, in the name of Zioka, in the name of SP Sumanoa. They have a huge role to play going forward. They have only 12 months to undo a million other things this team has brilliantly put in place and made sure and made us believe they have delivered beyond our wild imaginations.
Okay, the other thing you have to look at it, I don't think President Uhuru Kenyatta will leave this gentleman out in the cold. I mean, it's not in his nature. They will obviously have a safe landing. And as you rightly put it, I expect them probably to be appointed later on to be in charge of the communication at a political level. That's what they do best. And this is what actually the president may have realized, that look, these gentlemen are good, but this is where their strengths are. So it's just returning them to where they belong. So I expect them, when they're out there, they'll be able to do a better job.
All right, I must interrupt you a bit. Because we have Dennis here to me. Dennis, good evening, and thank you very much for joining us. Dennis, my first question,
yes.
What's your title right now? How should you?
My friend, I'm smart. First of all, how are you?
I'm good, Dennis.
Perfect.
Good talking to you.
I totally appreciate the whole conversation that has been going on. And I'll be the last person to try and bring an end to that conversation. I totally love it. I've been reading comments with a lot of amusement. So let's do this, Matt. As a person who works in the digital field, I will choose not to respond to that question because I know the answers will come over time. But I will tell you this. In the essence of fact-checking, because your program is called News Sources, you used a news source to confirm a story about hiring and firing. You know, that in journalism is actually a flaw. So I think the discussion should actually be, can you actually use a source to confirm about hiring and firing on an issue that is gazetted on public space?
All right, so help me as a source, since we are going to that route. So is Dennis Itumbi a source and the digital director as we speak tonight?
I don't think that has not changed. It hasn't.
Dennis.
But on KTN News, it has.
Dennis, there was a communication from the deputy director, Mr. Nzioka, to that effect. That aside, are you still in talk? You have been told to go home and wait for some time. Is it true?
Where? Do you have a statement, Mr. Dennis Ansariko?
There was a statement to that effect, Dennis.
No statement was issued. Someone was called by some Nzioka, so you don't even know whether it was Nzioka speaking or it was a petrol attendant. You have no idea.
Dennis,
there was no statement. If there is a statement, Mr. Ansariko, I challenge you to air it, and I will give you 50,000 shillings.
Dennis, Dennis, you're my personal friend, man. If you want to give me money, you can give me money out there, not here. But
Dennis, I'm challenging your topic.
Fine, Dennis, you're saying that there was no communication from anyone, that you've been relieved of your duties, and
there was communication on KTN News.
There was the same communication on Citizen TV, also a story number
one. Yeah, KTN News, Citizen TV. There was communication there, yes.
Dennis, are you still in talking terms with your friend, the President of the Republic of Kenya?
No, that is the wrong route, Mr. Ansariko, to go to. In terms of talking terms, I mean, the President is the President of the Republic of Kenya and I'm a citizen of the Republic of Kenya. So, I mean, I speak to everyone. I speak to Dennis Ansariko, I speak to Martha Karua, I speak to William Ruto, I speak to President Uhuru Kenyatta. I mean, surely that's the wrong conversation.
Okay, Dennis, now, assuming you're still the Director of Digital and Diaspora, do you feel you've done your job as you should have done it, or you're being vilified for doing a good job?
On the 12th of July, three years ago, we were appointed into office. And on the 12th of July this year, we are going to definitely be calling you, and I hope you'll be hosting me on your program. And I will detail to you what you account for every minute we have been in office, and we shall be in office until then. Then we are able to tell you what you have done and what you plan to do going forward.
Let me
give you an example. An obvious example is this. At the judiciary, we had the Chief Justice Willy Mutunga with a Twitter account called CJ Mutunga. When he left, the judiciary has no Twitter account. Even if we were to leave State House, as the KTN and other media houses seem to say, even if we were to leave, we would leave President KE, we would leave State House Kenya, we would leave PSU Digital. So we have been able to contribute to that conversation.
Well, it's good that let me allow my panelists to throw in questions.
Dennis, I don't like propaganda myself. I like when someone says something straight as it is. I mean, a question has been put to you and you are just simply to answer it. What is the problem with you saying, I haven't been asked to leave or
my
I have left?
My problem is I'm a trained journalist and it is not my job to verify KTN or Citizen sources. My job is to question, then KTN to answer.
You are the primary source here. I mean, the question has been put to you. Are you in office or not?
No. And I have answered that question. I have answered it more than twice in this conversation.
Okay, Dennis, since yesterday, this information came since yesterday and media has been scrolling it and running it since yesterday up to now. And we haven't confirmed any communication from State House apart from the one that came from Nzioka. Maybe now that we have the opportunity that you've called to talk to us, maybe just try to clarify, is it just a rumor or something is cooking or you're still in office?
That's what I told them, Sarigo. If you gave me a statement showing me that Nzioka signed something and gave to KTN, then I am able to get back to you and tell you that is a lie. But at this point, I don't even know whether you spoke to Nzioka or you spoke to a person who sits at KTN and pretended to be Nzioka. I have no idea. Until I know who was your source, then I'm able to call. Otherwise, I'll be reacting to every conversation in the market.
Dennis, have you had a chance of calling KTN or Citizen? National newspapers.
I respect the Kenyan media and therefore assume that they have serious editors. People like James Smart have gone to international schools. People like Dennis Ansariko have gone to the Kenyan Institute of Mass Communication and the University of Nairobi. I assume they are well trained to verify and also make sure their facts are right. So when they cannot, then my issue is just to challenge them to check, because even the normal process, who hires civil servants, who fires civil servants? What is the mandate of the different people? Just simple questions for them to be able to ask.
Dennis, I accept and I want to go with that line that possibly this news has not been confirmed. So for those who are watching and who do not know anything about yesterday up to today, is Dennis Itumbi the digital director still at State House? That's the question.
And at the point when we started this conversation, I told you and I gave you a straight answer and told you that that position has only changed in news.
Name?
Only in the news.
in the news.
All right, Dennis Itumbi. So as you, as a source, digital director, PSU, yes. Thank you very much for talking to us. And we hope that we'll have this discussion, you know, as we have more information coming from the appointing authority.
Now, before we take a short break, on our opinion Twitter poll question that we're asking you, do you feel the Jubilee government has been more about propaganda than development? Do you feel the Jubilee government has been more about propaganda than development? Tweeters at Dion Sarigo, at James Smart, and at KTN News. We're taking a short break, but do not go far. Itumbi, I hope you'll be tweeting also.